What up, YouTube? Good morning. Wow, I feel like I think I'm cut off here. What is going on with my camera? Oh. Hey, yo. All right. Good morning, good afternoon, wherever it may be, your time. We could probably move that back a little bit. I'm like making videos smaller over here. Welcome to Saturday. I just got back from a pumpkin patch and a farm. That's what you do when you're a dude who likes to watch college football on a Saturday. You get coerced into going to a pumpkin patch. I'm just kidding. I had a great time. Do me a favor. I'm looking at some Tim Minchin. Thank you, Troy, for the rec. I'm about to check out The Absence of You. Looks like a little bit older, Tim. This is 2 years old. By the way, I just looked. He only has like 430-some-odd thousand subscribers. Now, that sounds like a lot. He's way too talented to have anything less than a few million. So I need you guys to do me a favor and run over and support Tim. Like, subscribe to his content, please. At least check it out. Without me, I ruin everything. But go check it out on your own. He's widely diverse in his talents. So about to dive into some more of those right now, I feel like. But if you like what I do, please like, comment down below, subscribe. Let's dive into The Absence of You. Sounds like a love lost song. The Absence of You. Or somebody died. Let's go with love lost. I'm not trying to kill people on Saturdays. Have a good weekend. They're like picking up from a party. I think that's symbolic too. If we're talking about love loss, it's almost like he was staring at it, admiring a dance floor almost, and they have these party ribbons that are back there, and it's almost like he's sort of living in his past a little bit. Maybe this is where he had danced with somebody in times past, or he's remembering somebody, and he sort of just caught eye of a piano. And he's sort of by himself, just reminiscing, and he's like, fuck it, I'll play a song here. But it's the cleaning up of the party, you know, that's done on purpose, right? I'm sure Tim, if he was shooting a video, would have been like, can we get this guy out of here, please? Sorry, that was not loud enough for you guys.
I take a walk on the Seine, cross Pont Neuf on my way to Saint-Germain.
For my American friends, the Seine's a river, so he's in Paris right now, I think. He's in France. Pont Neuf, that's where the bridge is at, and Saint-Germain's on the other side. There's a lot of historic shit there. I think that's where like the padlocks are weighing down the bridge. You go there and you bring your girl, you lock something. I feel like it was like coming down and deteriorating, right? Wasn't that bridge where like it started sort of like not being able to hold locks? Anyways.
Love hearts on padlocks on
Okay. There you have it.
Wire in the mist where young lovers kiss and swear to be true. Echoes of 10,000 sighs of love, and yet I feel only the absence of you.
So it's right in that reminiscing space that he sort of started out in, where now he's remembering times. He might have been with this person at that place, right? So he's just thinking, and or maybe he was taking a walk earlier, and he's like, all right, well, and I'm not sure where this is shot. I don't think it really matters. He's just in a dark room, but it's more so symbolic than it is, you know. But anyways, so the absence of you, he's talking about reminders that, you know, keep your brain sort of dwelling on something, and you, no matter where you go, you're going to catch hints of things that you remember about somebody, right? Oh, I remember this time we were there, or I remember this time. And so all he's thinking is, you know, echoes of love in the air. And he's like, oh man, I had that.
Out of a window on the 30th floor, Central Park shines with the coming of dawn. Through
Central Park, did he just get to New York? What's Central Park in like where he's at? He's in London. Hyde Park. There's a lot of Central Parks in the UK. I know. Anyways.
Eyes rendered weary by jet lag and wine, I turn round to find there's a girl in my room. For a moment we kiss, but her vodka-soaked lips taste only of the absence of you.
Ah, okay. It's not his girl. He's trying to fill that space, that void in his heart with some floozy. I mean, she looks nice, but you know what I'm saying, right? You just... Sometimes you... When love is lost, your first instinct for me, I is, you know, instead of sit around and feel sorry for myself, you know, get back on the horse, you know, go find the nearest, you know, the nearest drinking hole that might have females, and whoever says I, all right, you're coming. I'm just kidding, but you know what I'm saying. We just got to a rock concert out of nowhere. So the hole in his heart is the pattern it creates is the absence. So basically, she's just sort of dwelling in his mind, now his heart, and it's just it's just expression. Essentially, everywhere he goes, he's just reminded. So this is, it sounds like this is fresh wounds, and the only thing that fixes that, it's a cliche, but they say, is time, right? And it's true. It does time does help. For sure, but there are always things that you're gonna remember and whatnot with lost loves. But yeah, so that's it's a sad song, you know. He's a lost man. He's kind of just wandering around, sad and trying to figure things out.
Spring has been found hanging round Soho Square.
Soho, all right, so he's back home. They're back in London. But all right, so we went from Paris, now we're back home.
So I take my coffee and newspaper there to bask in the not warm enough April sun with the workers who come to eat
the not warm enough April sun. Right, so it's chilling. It's cold for a reason. It doesn't feel warm to him anymore. It doesn't feel warm because he's cold inside. He's missing something inside. Lyrically, that's what he means with that. It's not that it's not warm enough outside for everybody. It's not that it's excessively cold in April. It's never going to be warm enough. Is kind of what he's saying. He's like that's just arbitrarily saying it. The not warm enough April sun, right?
Brett. With no shoes, workers who come to eat Pret with no shoes.
All right, American friends. So Pret is, it stems from French. Pret a porter is like ready to wear. Pret is basically ready to eat, but it's a chain. I think they have them in like the U.S. now too. Hong Kong, all over the U.K. Basically, it's like quick food. It's a sandwich shop. Not familiar. Haven't been. But I'm pretty sure that's what Pret is just like quick, ready-made, you know, sandwiches, foods, maybe salads, bowls, whatever. Something quick you can grab and go.
But the grass to the side of the patch where I'm lying is flat with the absence of you.
So everything, the grass, and so the grass is now flat with the absence. So everybody, everything he sees, there's imprints in his mind of her. He's visualizing, sort of metaphorically speaking, like her, the embodiment of her kind of silhouette in his emotions through his visions and what he's looking at kind of as he meanders around, right?
So we have a wonderful contemporary dancer and an orchestra. I love strings, by the way. And also he had set the violin down a minute ago, if you notice. But was that the same woman in the white dress or not? Because if it is, it could symbolize, and I wasn't paying enough attention to her face. It could symbolize, like, again, just distractions that he's creating, kind of dancing around in front of him. That he's just sort of disengaged as they, you know, as they sort of frolic about in his mind. Or if it's not, if that's supposed to symbolize the lost love, then that makes this representation a little bit easier, because she would there be, you know, sort of evading him, but still dancing around his thoughts symbolically, you know. And it's white, it's angelic, you know, it's, we have the light shining on her, so it's, it could be going that way too. But yeah, no, I mean, it's just trying to figure out the setup here. Space in my bed is cold as the dead. So we're back to being cold again, right? So that theme's carried without, as is the imprint of the absence of her, not just feeling the absence of her, actually seeing it.
And all of this beauty runs over and through me and pulls round my shoes. And the puddle it forms conforms to the shape of the absence of you.
Now he's alone again. So these are just thoughts and emotions he's sort of portraying through this song. I've never seen him on guitar, much less electric guitar in a rock setup, but the last line there, again, consistent with the theme of, so in using weather as, you know, as sort of a metaphor with emotions and whatnot, he was talking about lack of sunshine. So lack of brightness brings darkness. What brings darkness? Mood swings, right? Your mood changes when it's dark, when it's dreary outside, when it's rainy outside, when it's shitty outside. You feel that. And that's kind of the, regardless of how much sun there was, he was going to feel like it was too cold, right? Same with his own bed. Didn't feel warm enough, no matter how many blankets he would have grabbed, right? Same sort of thing. And with that sort of weather metaphor, right, we're talking about the rain coming down, and creating puddles around his feet. And then as he steps, right, it again takes the shape of the absence of you, of her, and that's, but that could also be, as you're stepping, you're moving forward, and those puddles are now behind you, right? So the absence of her, the imprints that they leave in those puddles, those are going to dwindle away with more water that falls down. So the more you allow yourself to, you know, to sort of take on the rain and go through that weather, for lack of a better term, to weather the storm, the less those puddles will take that shape. I feel like that's kind of where he's going. That's what I got from it. I could be way wrong. Tim's a genius, and he usually does a lot of things that I don't see. So, no, great, very, very different from there's, it's the first thing I've seen where there's absolutely nothing funny about it. I was waiting for a laugh. Nothing funny about this at all. Sweet though. And sad, but real. And as you, yeah, as you start to dive into, or as I've you older Tim stuff, you get a lot more serious sort of stuff. It's a lot less playful, and it's a lot more, you know, he doesn't have to sing about the irony of turtles, flying through outer space with dolphins and, you know, jokes and shit. I'm just making that up, but, now he has experiences built up, and probably lots of them, lots more of them at least, that he can use those to sort of catapult new adventures in song with you know, with different meaning that's not just comedic, which is great. I think that's it's cool. It's really interesting to see, because I never saw, I haven't yet seen a ton of the transformational part of a journey, right? I saw really, really older Tim, where it's just a bunch of fun, and then more recent stuff, which is a lot more serious or topical, and based on, you know, based on experience or actual events, right? The last three I did, I think, were the tribute to the Opera House, right, and being unique in the arts, a speech to a graduating class. There's humor in that, but again, you have to maintain some level of intellect and seriousness when addressing graduates who are all still impressionable. And this, which is geared towards love and love lost. So cool. No. Anyways, yeah, like I said, please go support Tim. You don't even need to support me. I talk too much. Go support Tim. Like, subscribe, please. If you like what I do, please like, comment down below. Subscribe. We'll keep it moving to the next.